Okay, how do I recommend to young people? A couple things. One, the resources back there are really going to be helpful, the CDs, the DVDs, so that way you can have a more robust answer than I can give in a soundbite. But I'd say a couple things. One, surround yourself with good friends. You always become like your friends. I mean, look, who is St. Francis Xavier's roommate in college? St. Ignatius of Loyola. Well, that kind of helps. Some of you at the university are like, my roommate's not a canonized saint. But you pick your friends, and you always become like your friends. So you got to pick friends who bring out the best in you instead of draw you away from God. That's huge. Second thing is we got to get rid of all the stuff that pollutes love, like pornography, swimsuit magazines, all that kind of junk. We got to trash it because it's crippling our ability to love. And some guys have like this porn habit, and some girls too, and they think, look, I'm not gonna kill the porn habit, I'll just try to cut down a little bit. But it's almost like this dragon that's there that they don't wanna slay. And so they're kind of walking around, kind of intimidated by it. But like, in order for you to get to your vocation, let's say your vocation is your wife over here, the princess in the castle, and the dragon of porn is standing between you, you can't just walk around that thing like, hey, how you doing? I'm just gonna kind of go around here, you just kind of stay there. And then, he's just gonna follow you right in that castle, he's gonna kill the both of you. What you gotta do is you gotta stare him down, you gotta cut his head off, walk over his corpse, and enter your vocation. You have to violently overcome these things and realize this thing could rob your whole vocation. You might be called to priesthood and you could miss your vocation because you're spending 10 years looking at porno websites instead of actually saying, God, help me overcome this thing. And these addictions can be tough, but with a good confessor, a good spiritual director, a good community, you can break free from this stuff. And when you do, you not only find more respect for others, you find a deeper respect for yourself as well. And so get fed with good resources, surround yourself with good friends, and only date a girl if you can truly see yourself marrying her. Because the point of dating is to find a spouse. And that means like when you date someone, it's like you're getting on a freeway with two exits, breakup and marriage, and that's it. If that's what dating is, there's no point of committing unless you can see yourself with this person forever and them raising your children. And so only if you think, well, I don't know this person well enough to know if they'd be a good person to date, that means you don't know them well enough. Stay friends longer. Build your love life on a foundation of your best friendship with this girl, because then you really know her. Because when you're dating a girl and you're dating a guy, when you meet a guy, it's easy to fall in love with who you think he is. Pope John Paul II in Love and Responsibility explained, when we fall in love, all of us do this. All of us, he said, do this. You come into that relationship with kind of a list of all the ideas of what you hope your future spouse is gonna be like. And then when you see any little bit of that quality in the person, you, beyond all measure of reasonableness, give them all of that quality. Meaning like if you're hanging out with a girl and she like feeds a poor person, oh, here's $5. You're like, oh, she's Mother Teresa. Okay, cool off, all right? She gave him $5, all right? But John Paul said this isn't something some people do some of the times. He said this is something all of us do all of the time. And that's okay, but what you can do is when you're falling in love, instead of just jumping into romance, take a little step back. Because girls, if you can step back, you can ask yourself some questions like, who is this guy? Like, no, really, who is this guy? I know he's cute and he's charming and he's funny, but like, how does he treat women? Like, how does he treat his mother? How does he treat girls he's not attracted to? Is he a drinker? What kind of guys does he hang out with? It'll tell you almost everything you need to know about a guy by the guys he chooses to hang out with. You could step back and think, okay, does this guy share my faith and morality, or does he just kind of put up with my faith and my morality? You guys can step back and say, okay, who's this girl? No, like really, who is she? Look, am I drawn to her because she's so pretty? Because she's like just so cute and charming? But like, what if every girl in the world look just like she does? What is it about her that would have drawn me to her? And so that period of friendship, you can get some answers to some really substantial questions, and that way you're dating a girl who can call you to be pure, and you can encourage each other. It's not the girl's job to be a chastity cop. We've got to be able to, because girls have their own temptations too. And if we're the ones who can just get away with whatever and she tells you when to say no, that's not a healthy relationship. I mean, there's going to be times she's tempted and she needs you to be strong. There's times you're going to be tempted, and you need her to be strong. And if you're in this thing together, you're going to have a much more healthy, balanced love. So, there you go.